Friends, today we will be seeing what is meant by Kappraeker's constant. Kappraeker's constant was discovered by D.R. Kappraeker, one Indian from Maharashtra. Okay, and he was predominantly involved in the recreational mathematics side. And his works were recognized. His works got recognition when the world famous puzzle enthusiast or puzzle authority called as Martin Gardner published his puzzles in his books, in his works. Okay, and what is Kappraeker's constant? Okay, take any four digit number. Only condition is this: those four digit numbers should have at least two different digits. That means they should not have one single digit for everything. Likewise, like you should not have 1111, 2222, etc. You can have different numbers like 4544 or 5873. In 4544, we have two different numbers, 4 and 5. Okay. So, and again in 5873, we have all the four numbers different, all the four digits different. Okay. So now what we are going to do with these numbers? Okay, first arrange the numbers in the ascending order as well as the descending order. 4544 can be written as 5444 in descending order and also as 4445 in ascending order. Subtract one from the other. So 5444 minus 4445 gives you 0999. Why we have put 0 before 999? Because in this procedure of Kappraeker's constant, we are involving only with two 4-digit numbers. So whenever you get a 0, you put it, and whenever you get a preceding 0, you put the preceding 0 before the number itself. Okay. Now we have to repeat the process. And with what number we have to repeat the process? We have to repeat the process with 0999. Okay, we have obtained 0999. This 0999 can be written as in descending order as 9990, and it can be written in ascending order 0999. What is the difference between 9990 and 0999? It is 8981. Okay, again you once again repeat the process. 8981 can be written in descending order as 9981. And in the ascending order, it can be written as 1899. What's the difference between 9981 and 1899? It is 8082. And we have to repeat this process again with the 8082. If we rearrange the number 8082 in descending order, we get 8820. And if we do it in the ascending order, we get 288. Okay, difference between this is 8532. Again you repeat the process. 8532, it can be rearranged as 8532, and it can be written in the ascending order as 2358. So what is the difference between 8532 and 2358? It is 6174. So once you obtain 6174, this is the Kappraeker's constant. But you check it, how will you find out that this is the Kappraeker's constant? You again redo this work. Rearrange 6174 into ascending and descending order. So if you do it in the descending order, you get 7641, and if you do it in the ascending order, you get 1467. 7641 minus 1467 is equal to 6174. So here we are getting 6174 repeatedly. From now onwards, we won't be getting any other number. The same number will be repeated. This 6174 is the Kappraeker's constant for 4-digit number. Once we arrived at this decision, a conclusion that 6174 is the Kappraeker's constant for 4-digit number, and as curiosity arises in our mind, whether there is any Kappraeker's constant in 3-digit number or any other digit number. Okay, but in 3-digit number, there is another Kappraeker's constant available. We will see about that shortly. And in the 5-digit number, there is no Kappraeker's constant available, but we will see this 3-digit number. Okay, Kappraeker's constant for 3-digit number. The rules governing are the same for 3 digit as well as 4 digit number. The rules governing are the same. That is, no number should occur all the 3 times. Okay. For example, you should not have numbers like 555 or 444, etc. But you can have numbers like 567, 566, etc. Well, at least in 566, you have got 2 different numbers. So with these 2 different numbers, we can make some, what do you say, ascending order and descending order, we can make it out. Now we'll take for example 566. Okay, 566 can be rearranged as 665 and 566. You get 099. 099 you can write it in descending order as 990, and 099 is naturally done as 099 only, descending order. Ascending order it is 099 only. 990 minus 099 is equal to 891. Okay. 891 we can do it in descending order as 981. 981 minus 189 is equal to 792. Okay. Once we get this 792, we have to move on the next stage. Okay. Once we arrive at this 792, we will again do the rearrangement in descending order as well as in the ascending order format. 792 can be done as rearranged as 972 in descending order and 279 in ascending order. 972 minus 279 gives you 693. Okay. And 693 you do again descending order and ascending order. Okay. In the 693, okay, you can do it in descending order as 963 and ascending order as 369. So difference what you get? 594 you get. This 594 you do it in rearrange it in descending order, you get 954, and in ascending order you get 459. Okay, so what is this 954 minus 459? You get 495. This 495 is the Kapreker's constant for any 3 digit number. How do you find out? We repeat this process. 495 we can write it as 954 in descending order and 459 as ascending order. So 954 minus 459, again you get 495. So again, from here onwards, no matter how many times you rearrange, you will be getting the same number, 495. Therefore, this 495 is called the Kapreker's constant for any 3 digit number, and 6174 is the Kapreker's constant for any 4 digit number. This is just a very recreational way of enjoying mathematics. Okay, we will see with more such concepts in the coming videos. Kindly subscribe to my channel to get more of these kind of videos to your inbox. Thank you. Good day.